Hey guys, John Place here. A few months ago, I posted a YouTube video on my FATMAX Airbrush paint setup, and I got a lot of positive responses, and I also got lots and lots of people asking me how I actually made it, as in what tools I used, the size of the holes, how I drilled the holes, how I placed the fan in the front, things like that. So that's what this video is going to be. This is going to be a how to build your own FATMAX or transform your old FATMAX into your own portable airbrush system workstation type of thing. Okay, so let's get started. All right, so obviously the first thing you're gonna need is a FATMAX toolbox. I got this at Home Depot. They cost about $79 with tax and everything, comes out to about $84, and that is the FATMAX. All right, so for the tools, it's pretty simple. I mean, if you have the tools, great. If you don't, you know, you can probably borrow them from somebody, or maybe, you know, you have a next door neighbor, you know, that can help you out, something like that. First, you're gonna need a drill. This is just a normal little power drill, okay? Then you're gonna need some screwdrivers. You're gonna need, these are pretty much, they're just hole drills or hole bits. The one we're gonna be using today is a 1.5 inch or a 38 millimeter bit here like this. This is a bigger one, we're not gonna use this, but this is a Milwaukee brand. I got them from Home Depot and they cost around, I would say between $8 and $10 for one of these. So that's those. You're gonna use a Dremel tool to create the hole in the front of the box. For the fan, you're gonna need a hot glue gun and some glue sticks to put this piece of foam. We're gonna cut it up, put it inside where the holes are. That way when you drop the paint into the holes, it won't go all the way, you know, just fall through the bottom. It'll have something to catch it. You'll see that once we get going. Or if you've watched my other video, you know what I'm talking about. There's various, this is for my Dremel tool, various cutters and drill bits and things like that. They usually come in a kit when you buy one of these tools. And then a computer fan. I got this at Tiger Direct, or it used to be CompUSA. Go to your local computer store, they usually have them. It's about $10. It's a 12 volt fan. The airflow is about 44 CFM. So it pushes a lot of it'll push a lot of air into the case. This is, like I said, I think is about $10. I got this for. Also, we have some airbrush bottles, airbrush gun, a manifold. This, a lot of people ask me where I get my manifold from, and I got this from Silly Farm Supplies. You go from the compressor into this end, and then you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 hoses that come out into 6 air guns. Some of the paints that fit really well inside these 1.5 inch or 38 millimeter holes are Fab. The Fab paints, they fit perfectly in the holes. Pretty much most companies that have the 2 ounce bottles, they'll fit in the hole. If you're going to use 4 ounce bottles, then you'll have to put a bigger hole, and there is space in the box to put those holes. Not as many. I think you could probably fit maybe 3 or 4 of the bigger holes, and you can put 7 of the smaller 1.5 inch holes. All right, so the first thing we're going to do is we're going to drill the holes in the top here. Now, how I do that and how I keep them nice and straight is this. Inside the lid, oops, let me turn it this way. Inside the lid, you'll see these little, I don't know, these little plastic bars that go back and forth, okay? What we're going to do is we're going to put them right here, the holes, okay? And if you count here, what I do is every place where there's a point like this, that's where I put the drill bit. So what's cool is it kind of lines it up and it fits perfectly in this area, okay? So if you count, I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 spots. Okay, so I can put 7 colors in here. Usually, like this manifold here, it only has 6 outputs. So I'll usually put 3 on one side, 3 on the other side. In the center, I'll put a glitter or an extra paint or some kind of other bottle. I'll maybe even put some business cards in there or something like that. This blade goes through the plastic pretty well. You'll see in a second. You can't do multiple holes. Once you do one hole, you have to open it and you have to pluck out the little piece of plastic that's left in here. I'll show you that now. So let's do the first one. Support it with your hand. Don't put too much pressure. You don't want it to pop the hinges here when you're pressing down. So just kind of hold it with your hand. Make sure your hand's not in the way and make sure it's going in the correct direction. And let's do it. Oops. This drill has, wait, gotta fix it. No, not that way. Let's do it this way. Should have checked that first. And there's that. And you'll see here, see how it's all in there? If I tried to do the next hole, it wouldn't really go through. So you just kind of pick this out, throw it on the floor. Probably shouldn't have done that. Probably should have thrown it in the garbage, but whatever. Okay. Hopefully this drill, the battery holds up. Usually I have an electric drill, but I don't have you here with me today. So let's hope we get through this. We'll do the next one. There's two. That one already fell out. Do the next one. Whoop. Okay, that drill died. I found another drill in the office. This one seems a lot stronger, so we should get through these holes pretty easily. The last three, let's try it. Yeah, that worked really well. Again, pop out this little plastic piece. If it gives you, oh, there we go, got it. I wouldn't suggest doing this over carpet the way I am. It's gonna be a pain picking up all these tiny little pieces, but it's all in good fun. Let's do the next part. And one last hole. If I can get this one out. There it is. Sometimes you just work it. There it is. And last hole. There you go. Okay, so one thing you will get when you drill out these holes is you see here along the edges, it kind of sticks out. What you have to do is you just have to get a little razor like this. Like this. And I just kind of just go around the edge and just take that off. You know, it takes a few minutes, just kind of, you know, get all the rough parts off. Usually if you could hold it flat like this and just go across, it works pretty well. Don't cut your fingers, please. Don't want to do that. Want to make sure everybody has all their fingers. And you just kind of go across and just get that off like that. All right, so I cleaned up the outer ridges here. Now to get the little leftovers that are inside, you can just use your Dremel tool and just kind of, you know, nick them and they'll come off. So let's just, we'll do a couple of those and then move on to the next step. All right, so the next step, after you've drilled your holes, you touched up the edges, you made the holes nice and finished and nice, you're gonna put foam inside of the case so that when you drop your paints into the holes, they don't just fall straight through. There's something for them to rest on. Whoops, something for them to rest on, okay? So I'm using this foam. I found it at Silly Farm. They have a big pile of it, so that's why I'm using this. You can use foam board. You can use you know, other types of plastic. You can use cardboard, things like that. We're gonna attach that just using hot glue from a hot glue gun. I got it at Michael's for maybe $5, something like that. So we're gonna use that. All right, so what I'm gonna do is I'm going to take this foam and put it on this side so that when you close it, the paints don't fall through. As you can see, this is a little too short, so I'm probably gonna have to cut it pretty much here. Find the next piece, measure it up, put it here, things like that. Another thing that works well is you see this, it's kind of on an angle, okay? So it doesn't really fit nice and flat. So what I'll do is I'll come in and I'll cut like a little piece like this so it actually goes a little, you know, smoother in and make it nicer. I only come to about pretty much right here with it at this line across. I don't really go further back because there's no need and you'll just need more foam. So I'll cut this up using just a razor. You know, one of these little utility knives, and we'll cut that up and I'll show you how to glue it in. Okay, so I went ahead and I cut these pieces, so now they'll fit nicely in here like this. and like this, and they pretty much match up, so it looks nice and clean. You know, it doesn't look very, doesn't look out of place, okay? So what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna grab my hot glue gun, which I hope is hot. And you gotta work pretty quick, because once you put it down, it starts getting hard and it doesn't really go on. So I'll usually do a little piece first, and I just kind of go on all these little ridges, you know, put bigger blobs in the cross portions, and then little blobs here. You don't have to do all of it. Just like I said, you want to get it while it's still hot. Then I'll just get this and I'll press it down like that and just hold it so it cools down nicely. Again, don't just press down, hold it, you know, secure it with your hands so you don't break the hinges. You don't want to do that. And then once I get it in, I'll usually just, you know, go over the seam, you know, plop some down in here, make sure it sits nice, go along this edge here. Get it down in there. And then we'll do the same over here. You know, get it down there. There you go. Put some more in here. I probably cut this a little too big, but it's okay. It'll still serve its purpose. It'll work fine. Okay. Okay, so now what we're going to do is we're going to install the fan on the front of this box here. This is a 120 millimeter fan. It's a computer fan. Like I said, it's 12 volts. It'll run on a 12 volt adapter. Now, when you put it on, you can try to find something long and sharp and kind of poke holes to know where the, you know, where your screws go in. Or there's a really cool thing. I don't know where I learned it. I can't remember. It might have been off a website or something like that, maybe lifehacker.com. I don't really remember. But what I do is, and it's great for everything, for hanging clocks, for hanging picture frames, things like that, is what you do is you take the fan and you put it onto a copy machine and you scan it and copy it out. And now you have an exact placement of where all the holes are. So wherever you place this, you can just drill the holes right there and you know they're gonna fit on here. Okay, so I thought that was kind of a pretty cool trick. I use it all the time. It works well. So that's what we're gonna do on the front of this box. I'm gonna cut this out as a template and then we're gonna place our holes, drill the center out for the fan so that the air can flow through and go from there. So let's do that. Okay, so the first thing I'm gonna do is I cut out my template, so I'm going to place that where I want it. You know, I'm going to put it actually in the center, okay? Take some tape. I want to tape it down so it doesn't shift when I'm making my holes. Make sure it's centered. Because once you make the hole, it's permanent. That's going to be its new home right there, okay? All right, so the fan, when you buy it, it comes with four set screws already. So what you're going to do is you're just going to drill a hole right inside the hole that's in your template. Then you know it's in the right place. There's one, two, three, four. Okay. Now, remove that, you have your four holes. Okay, so the next thing I'll do now is we have to mark where the hole in this fan is, okay? So pretty much you can line up all the holes, like this here. And then I just take a Sharpie, and I just mark where the hole is. There you go. That's the hole. Okay. All right. So the next thing we have to do is we have to cut out this hole. I just use this little tool here on my Dremel. It looks like a normal drill bit, but actually what it does is when you go in, it actually cuts. So when you move it, you can actually, it'll cut out your circle for you. You need to start off. So I just take a know, my same drill bit from before. You can start on the edge or you can start in the center. We'll start kind of near the edge. Make it big enough so this one will fit in. And I don't usually go right to the line. I kind of stay inside the line a little bit. It just makes it look prettier at the end. So let's do that. Now I know what you're thinking. That hole looks a little rough. Well, yes, it does. So now I'm just gonna get my trusty old grinder. We're gonna swap out this tool. Oops, we're gonna swap out this bit for this bit. We're gonna make it nice and smooth. And that's pretty good. Okay. Edges are already pretty nice now. I'll sand it down. Okay, so now what I did was I just set the case upright. These screws that come with the fan, these little screws here, they actually screw from the inside out, and which is cool, is it gives it a nice clean finish. You wanna, for power for the fan, what I do, it's a 12-volt fan, so I'm going to cut this connector off right here. And what I did is I just looked around the house. And I guarantee if you look in some old drawers or you look in a closet or you look in the garage, you're going to find a 12-volt adapter. I found this one from an old hard drive, external hard drive I have. I just cut off the end. Now you have to make sure, let's see if it'll see in here. You have to make sure that the output is 12 volts. It says it right there, the tip of my finger, 12 volts. If it's too much, you're going to blow up the fan. If it's too little, it's not going to spin as fast probably. So you want to make sure you have a 12-volt adapter, okay? Now, you're going to plug this into the wall before you install it to find out which way the air is flowing. This fan actually flows outward, so it actually pushes the air out this way. Whoops, I'm sorry, pushes the air out. What I want is I want the air to flow in to the box and out through the holes that I drill next, okay? So I'm gonna spin this around this way when I install it, okay? So let's do that now. All right, so before you secure all the screws, make sure that you run the wire in through the back here, okay? Let me just tighten up the last two. And it's nice and secure, it's on there, okay? It looks nice and clean. You don't see what I mean? Looks nice and clean. Okay, next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna put holes along the sides on each side and two holes in the back to allow the air to flow through. It brings the cool air from the outside into the inside and pushes all of the warm air from the compressor out, okay? So let's do that. And now the other side. You want to make sure there's a lot of ventilation because your compressor will, if it overheats, it'll stop. So you want to make sure a lot of air is flowing through. Okay, as for wiring, like I said, all you have to do is take this connector, cut these wires here. Clean these up. That takes a little bit of practice. So yeah, just plug this in here. Grab the ends. See which way, which one operates the fan. That way it doesn't, so it must be this way. Ah, there it goes, it's turning. Nice. So what I'll do is I'll just take some electrical tape, which I don't have any right now, so I'm not gonna do it, but you'll get the idea. Twist these wires up, or you can use wire caps, wire nuts, which is probably even better than the duct tape. But I'm not gonna do that right now because I don't have any with me. What I usually do is, when I have everything packed in here nicely, I'll usually run an extension cord. I could take this cord now and actually keep it inside. So I just have one cord coming out of the box on the side here. So when I start my job, I can just plug this in, keep my compressor inside here, the fan's blowing. Now here's a little word of caution, okay? This does not have a fan guard. So if you put your finger in there, it could hurt, okay? You don't want a little kid to walk up and put their finger in there or their tongue. I know that sounds weird, but they'll do it. So usually what I'll do is I'll turn my case away from them so that they won't have the to go on there. Another cool thing so that you know that it's spinning is like in the old airplanes or even airplanes now, just get a marker, start from the center, pull it out, there. Yeah, there it is. So now you know it's spinning. Okay, now back to the top portion of this. Foam is dry now, so it should be pretty secure. Like pressing down on it, it's pretty solid. So whenever I take my paints now, with my guns attached, they'll sit right on top like this. See, they stick nicely out there. When the gun's on top of it, it's, you know, it's right here. They're easy to grab, to remove, put them back in, okay? Like I said, there's seven holes. So usually what I'll do is I'll have three on this side, three on this side, and then the center one I can put glitter or I can, you know, put pretty much anything I want right there in that spot. When I run my manifold, and you'll see, if you watch my other video, you'll see how I have everything set up. But I usually lift this up. I'll stick my manifold here, kind of like that. Run my compressor wire out of one of these small holes, still on the side, up to here. I'll take these three, go around to these three guns, take this three around to these three guns, and it keeps everything nice and separated, okay? All right, guys, so here's the video you've been asking for, how to transform your FATMAX toolbox into an airbrush workstation. Again, the 2 ounce fab bottles fit great in here. There's other companies that also have the same size bottles that fit well. I believe Phoenix, I know that Pro Airs, they're fit. I have fab in the studio. These are by Silly Farm Supplies. So they gave me these to use in this this demonstration. Also, I have, you know, you're gonna need airbrushes. The Neo Start Brushing Now set, the Iwata Neos. These are pretty good. They're low cost. They have bottom feed and top feed. For airbrush tattooing, I suggest to use bottom feed. That way, you know, you can just put in a blast cap and go. The top feeds are great for like smaller makeup applications or special effects, things like that. So the Neo by Iwata, they're really good. In my other video, I show you where I get cheaper things, like cheaper airbrushes and cheaper things. The manifolds by the cheaper companies are very, very cheap. They stink. They leak all over the place. They're no good. The ones by Silly Farm, I have this in my kit, and they never leak. They're very, very strong and sturdy, so they'll last you for a long time. For prices, I'm not sure what these run. You can go on the Silly Farm website at sillyfarm.com. Also, be sure to check out fabatv.com, where we fly in artists from all over the world to teach one-on-one classes online, face painting, body painting, marketing, special effects, makeup, all kinds of classes. So be sure to check that out if you're not already a subscriber. You'll love it. Okay, so again, I'm John Place. I hope you learned a lot from this video, and we'll see you next time. Bye.